Hola, hola. My name is Ramon, cosmetic formulator and sunscreen fanatic, and today we're talking about my favorite sunscreens for reapplication, specifically with and without makeup. One of the questions I get the most is how I reapply sunscreen on top of makeup specifically. Generally, I tend to prefer cream and lotion-based textures over sprays and powders for reapplication, both with and without makeup, just because for me, it's kind of guaranteeing you're getting more adequate, more consistent protection. That being said, I am testing out some sprays. I am kind of figuring out what works besides just creams and lotions, but do note, I will be uploading more dedicated sunscreen videos based on specific skin types and concerns, so make sure you hit the subscribe button to see when those go live. For all the products I'm gonna mention today, being sunscreen lotion textures, I tend to reapply these over makeup generally by using a sponge or a cushion puff. If you're not wearing makeup though, as long as your hands are clean, these are really good options to reapply with your hands on top of a bare face as well. Having oily skin, I tend to blot beforehand just to be sure. But that being said, you can't always do that. So some of these, especially the first few I'm gonna mention, are really good for reapplying if you know you're kind of greasy throughout the day, just because there are a little bit more oil controlling, more mattifying finish. First and foremost, arguably my holy grail sunscreen of the year thus far, and that is from Eucerin. It's their Dry Touch Oil Control Sunscreen. This is one that just hit it out the park for me. It's just a beautiful, lightweight gel texture that just sinks into the skin. And with that, it just applies on top of makeup beautifully, sets in without altering the finish or wear of the makeup at all. And that one specifically is oil controlling, so it does control oil production for 8+ hours, honestly. And so on top of makeup, it just helps to ensure a very oil-free, semi-matte to natural finish throughout the entire day. So with that in itself, love that sunscreen. Next is a Japanese option. This one's from Biore. It's their Athleisme Skin Protect Essence. This is a sunscreen that does have a high alcohol content in it. With that, it just causes it to set into the skin really, really quickly. This one is a favorite for me, having oily, acne-prone skin, just because I can put this on top of makeup and know it's gonna set down real quick. It's not gonna alter anything. It's gonna be an option that keeps me nicely oil-free throughout the entire day. This one is also water-resistant, which is worth noting because this is one I will definitely be reaching for more during the summer, if that's the case. But a really great, elegant gel texture, melting right away. Love it. Very similar to the Athleisme one. This is from Suncut. This is their UV Perfect Gel Sunscreen, super waterproof. And this one pretty much hits all the same check marks as the last one. It sets down really quick. It does have alcohol in it. It leaves a nice natural finish and is super water resistant throughout the day as well. So super similar experience for each of those. This I think is a little bit more affordable. This one ranges around $10 to $15 depending on where you get it. So just note that, but same experience overall. And again, because it's water resistant, this is one I will reach for more during the summer. Another European sunscreen that's really, really good for oily skin types specifically is from La Roche-Posay, and it's their Anthelios Chaka Fluid Sunscreen. And that is one that is a really interesting experience overall. It's a super, super lightweight, very liquidy sunscreen. It's super runny. So putting it on is a little bit of a feat. But that being said, because it's such a lightweight, watery texture, reapplying it over makeup, beautiful. That one just goes on top of makeup and just sets down quickly, doesn't affect anything. And honestly, it doesn't feel like you're wearing anything. You can't tell you have sunscreen on at all. So with that, it's a really good option. Plus, it is water, sweat, and sand resistant, which is really fun marketing, and it has a really high photoprotective value. It has a UVA PF of like 46 and an SPF of 50+. So you're getting very, very transparent results in terms of what they're advertising with that one. So it's a really good option if heavy duty sun protection is really important to you. Next is an option from Garnier. It's the Garnier Ombre Solaire Sensitive Advanced Face UV Face Fluid SPF 50+. And this is one that's very similar to the La Roche-Posay Anthelios Chaka Fluid. Similar texture to me. This one is just a little bit more mattifying, a little bit more oil controlling throughout the day. Similar texture though, similar wear. This is a lot more of an affordable price point though. This is about £8 here in the UK, but for me, this is just if I'm leaning a little bit more towards the matte side, what I'd reach for instead. And then this is one from Village 11. This is a Korean sunscreen and it's called their Hydra Sun Fluid. This was really interesting to me because as a sunscreen itself, it has a very primary finish to it, has a primary feel to it. So this goes on super lightweight and it kind of blurs pores, prep the skin nicely for makeup. But because of that primer finish, generally primers aren't the best for preparing your face for makeup. They have the tendency to pick up pigment and kind of ruin the makeup underneath them. That being said, this one reapplies beautifully on top of makeup. It's a really nice lightweight texture that just sinks into the makeup. This starts to deviate a little bit more from that really matte finish. It gives you more of a natural semi-radiant finish. But if you have oily skin, it's still a really beautiful option. And this is one I was just really shocked by how nicely it applied over makeup. So if you have oily skin and you're looking for something that helps to diffuse pores, kind of give you a nice oil controlled finish, this is good for initial application and reapplication as well. And then next is one of my all-time holy grail sunscreens. This is from The Same and it's their Eco Earth Power Aqua Sun Gel. The reason this stood out to me when I first bought it and why I've come back to it year after year after year is just that it has such a lightweight texture to it. It just sinks into the skin, but it's a little bit more of a moisturizing finish as well. This gives your skin a more natural to semi-radiant finish that's still very oily skin friendly. It's super lightweight. And so on top of makeup, just this goes on beautifully. It doesn't affect the makeup underneath it. It just gives your skin a little bit more of a radiant glow throughout the day. So if you don't mind radiance and you want something that's going to be super lightweight reapplication, very simple, very foolproof, this is one of my favorite options. This does have a fragrance to it that's very nice, very light, very sweet, and that's one of the other things I love about it. So do note that, but beautiful sunscreen. And then a very popular option, this is from CanMake, it's a Japanese sunscreen. It's their Mermaid Skin Gel UV. This one is alcohol free, fragrance free, very hydrating, very, very lightweight gel texture. So similar to all the other gel ones, it just sinks in the skin, melts in right away. You can't tell you're wearing it. But being alcohol free, it's something that people look for in the sunscreen. So definitely a really good option. Small packaging. So with that, I wish it was a lot bigger, but it's still a very beautiful experience. I really enjoy the sunscreen. So definitely worth trying out. And next from Essentreat, this is their Hyaluronic Acid Watery and gel. This in itself is a very hydrating sunscreen. The finish for this is more natural to radiant, so not the most oil controlling, but still a really good option for every skin type, honestly. And this is one that just on top of makeup and this reapplication is super lightweight. You don't really feel it. It's not greasy. And it gives your skin a radiant finish, but it's not greasy in any capacity. There's very minimal emollients, like rich greasiness to it. So with that, that's why I really like this for reapplication if I want more of a radiant finish throughout the day or if I don't need oil controlling. This one is also fairly affordable as well. It's about $12. So it's a really good Korean option, especially if you have dehydrated skin. Coming back to Biore, this is their Aqua Rich Watery Essence Sunscreen. This one does have alcohol in it, but compared to the Athleism one, this one has a more radiant, hydrated finish. So similar to the Essentreat one I just mentioned, you're gonna get a very supple, very dewy finish with this, but again, it's super lightweight. It's a gel texture that just sinks right in. This does have alcohol, which kind of helps aid in that setting in process. But that being said, it is a very plush, hydrating texture. I think Biore hits sunscreen formulations out of the park. They have really beautiful textures and experiences with them. And that being said, this one is also water resistant as well. So definitely one to check out, especially if during the summer you have more dehydrated skin and you want a more radiant finish, but you're someone that sweats a lot or you're going to be exercising and you want that sunscreen to stay on. Really great for reapplication throughout the day as well. And next is one I can't neglect to talk about. It's the Fenty Hydra Visor. With this one, again, this just has a specific finish to it. I can't put my finger on it why it does it, but it gives your skin a beautiful radiant glow that's very smooth and it just makes your skin look amazing. This is alcohol free. It does have fragrance though, so do note that, but it's a super lightweight gel texture that reapplies beautifully on top of makeup. With the Fenty skin products, they work amazingly with Fenty Beauty products, and we know I pretty much exclusively only use Fenty Beauty products, so that's why for me this works really well for reapplication. Those products just hand in hand go well together, but this does go well on top of other makeup products. So if you have more dry skin or you do not mind a very radiant, very glowy finish, definitely one worth checking out. Also just because I love the smell of this, so just making sure I have that smell on me all throughout the day, I'm not complaining. And then last is from Garnier. This is their NCH Super UV SPF 50. This is one that is just a very nicely lightweight moisturizing sunscreen. This sits beautifully on the skin. I think it's a really good option for all skin types, but this one is also alcohol free. But that being said, it's a super lightweight texture that just with reapplication, you're going to apply layer after layer after layer. It's not going to be heavy and greasy on the skin. You're just going to have a nice radiance to the skin. So with that, the fact that it's super affordable, it is also alcohol free, not water resistant though, this is a really beautiful option for reapplication throughout the day. And with that, those are all my favorite sunscreens for reapplication, both on a bare face and with makeup. So hopefully you found an option that's going to work for you, but also let me know down below in the comments what some of your favorite sunscreen options for reapplication are. Love hearing what you guys love to use. Make sure you hit the subscribe button, notification bell, so that you know when I post more skincare, sunscreen, and Fenty related content on my channel. Give me a thumbs up and thanks for watching, guys. Bye.